Hi guys, in this video, I'm going to talk about version history in Adobe Illustrator CC, and I am in the newly updated version 25.1, and Illustrator has added a lot of new features, and it's pretty exciting. So if you're using Illustrator on the iPad and you've been doing radial repeats and mirrored repeats, those are now available inside of Adobe Illustrator on the desktop. So this is very exciting. In fact, let me just show you really quickly. Object, and then if we just go down here to repeat, then you have the three types here, radial, grid, and mirror. Now these are all grayed out currently because I don't have any artwork selected that I'm going to use any of these features on, but I just wanted to point out where you can find that. So now you can open up files that you have created on your iPad and work on them in Illustrator and edit the repeat. So this is great, but it does bring up one subject that I want to talk about because this is something I've been dealing with on my own. Now I'm kind of old school. I've been working in Illustrator for a really long time and I've adopted cloud documents. I've been working on my iPad, working on my desktop. And one thing that I have is an old habit that I need to change. And that is a habit involved in working with documents that are saved to the cloud in Illustrator. So if I come in and I try to edit some artwork like this that I created on the iPad, normally what I would do is make some edits and maybe decide, you know, I don't like any of these edits that I made, and I'll just close the file in order to sort of revert to the last version to not save any of my changes. So I would close it without saving. Well, with cloud documents, this just isn't possible because they're saved continuously as you work and when you close them. So if I go up here and see, this is a cloud document. I see the little cloud icon. So my habit is changing. Now I'm gonna go and when I do edits here that I don't wanna save, I might go back and undo them before I close the document. But here's another tip. You can use this version history panel here. Well, where do we get that? It's in the window menu, all the way down at the bottom here, version history. And when you open this panel, you can see the version history for the file that you're working on. So let me go ahead and collapse some of this. So what we see are marked versions, today's version, and then everything that I did to this file that I created in December. So if I click on this caret to turn it down, I can see all these dates and times, earlier versions that Illustrator has saved. And as I click on them, you'll see the preview in this window change. And so when I started playing with this repeat, I had the centers of these flowers sort of nicely aligned. But now I think with this repeat, I've added one too many flowers and now the centers that were in these corners here have gotten off. And I wanna go back and find one where I have a flower aligned with a flower center here in each corner. So this right here could be the version I wanna revert to. Let's look here and this three dot menu, and I can choose to name this version. I can also choose to revert to this version. Let me choose that. And then Illustrator is going back and getting that version. So let me zoom in a little bit here. And this is exactly what I wanted before I came in and messed everything up. So now this version, as we can see, is right here. So this is the top version. But if I need to, I can always go back to today and maybe get this earlier version here, the one that I kind of messed up. So they're all here, but one thing that you really want to know is that, and there's a lot of them here, it's saving every, you know, just by the minutes here. Something that you need to know is that these versions, once they're 30 days old, they're no longer saved. But what you can do is go in and see these flags right here. You can say, ah, this is a version that I want to flag. This is one that I want to make sure that Illustrator hangs on to for me. So I'm going to say old version and hit enter. And what this means now is that this is a saved version that will not be affected by that 30-day expiration date. So that's great. Now let's just take a look at how version history and this version history panel relates to the Creative Cloud desktop app. So I'll click on the Creative Cloud icon to open Creative Cloud on the desktop. And here's the file. And if you want to see its version history here, then just go over to this little three-dot menu. There's a menu of all kinds of things you can do with this file here, but let's click on this and view this on the web. Then it's going to open the file in a browser window, which I have to move into the frame here. And as we can see, I can make comments on this. That's great if you're collaborating with other designers. And then here, if I look in the timeline, I can see the different versions and the marked versions that I just created. You'll also be able to see the same view if you look on the iPad. So just going to the home screen of Illustrator on the iPad, I can go right here to my file and click on the little menu icon. And then at the bottom, click on View Version History. And this takes me into the same panel where I have all of my earlier versions that I can choose from. So now the more you work between Illustrator on the iPad and on the desktop, this version history panel is going to become a really important part of your workflow if it hasn't already. If this video has been helpful to you, please give it a like and share it. My name is Laura Coyle. I give Illustrator tips here on my YouTube channel and on my website at lauracoylecreative.com. Thank you for watching.